In this video, we will solve the problem number 7.14 from the chapter number 7. The problem is, it is necessary to formulate the Hamming code for 4 data bits D3, D5, D6 and D7 together with 3 parity bits, and the parity bits are P1, P2 and P4. Okay, so we have to formulate the Hamming code for this given data bit. In the first part of the problem, we have to evaluate the 7-bit composite code word for the data word 0010. That means this value are nothing but D3, D5, D6 and D7 values are given. Okay, in the second part, we have to evaluate the 3 check bits C4, C2 and C1, assuming there is no error. So here we have to check the composite word in which there is no error, and we have to show that for this we have the check bit all 3 are 0. In the third part of the problem, we have to assume an error in the D5, that is the data 5 value. We have to consider an error during writing into the memory. While writing into the memory, suppose there is an error in the D5 bit. Then so how the error in the bit is detected and corrected. That means we have to use the Hamming code and we have to detect the error and we have to correct it. In the fourth part of the problem, we have to add a parity bit P8 to include the double error detection in the code. So in the case of Hamming code, we have single error detection and single error correction. But in the fourth part of the problem, we have to add one extra parity bit, that is P8. Okay, that will detect the double error in the code. Now assume that the errors occurred in the bits P2 and D5. Now we have 2 errors in the detected bit, and we have to show how the double error is detected. Okay, now let us solve this problem. The given data sequence is 0010. Now let us write down here the composite word. The composite word is, so at the first position we will have, suppose let us write down here the bit position 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, so in the first position we'll have the parity bit 1 P1, then we have parity bit P2. We have already seen how we have considered this parity bit in our previous questions. Please go through problem number 7.10, 7.11, 7.12 and 7.13. This third position bit is the data bit D3. So this fourth bit is parity bit P4. And here we have this data bit D5, then D6 and D7. So these are the data bits. So here we are given with these data bits are 0010. So at this data bit positions, we have to put these values 0, 0, 1 and 0. Now we have to find out this parity bit values P1, P2 and P4. Okay, so for finding out parity values, we have already seen that the parity bit P1 we can calculate using the XOR operation, XOR of bits. So here we will write down the bit positions. They are, so for P1 we will have to consider only the data bits. So after this P1 we have to see the higher order bits. So starting with D3, we have to consider the data bits only. So here we have D3, D5 and here we'll have D7. Why I have considered these values? For P1 we have to consider one data bit, then we have to skip another. Next we will have to consider this bit, and then we have to skip this D6. Next we have to write this D7. Okay, now we have to do the XOR operation between these bits. So D3 value is 0 XOR, D5 value is 0 XOR, then D7 value is 0. So here we can see, so D3 value is 0, D5 value is 0 and D7 value is again 0. Yeah, this one. So 0 XOR 0 XOR 0 will have 0. So we have got that P1, that is parity P1 value is 0. Next we will consider P2. So P2 will be the XOR of bits. So what are the bits? So for P2 we have to take 2 bits at a time. So after P2 we have to see, we have to consider D3. Then we do not have a data bit in this position, so we have to skip this P4 because we do not have a value here. So if we skip P4, then we have to skip P5, Okay, then we will consider this D6 and D7, 2 bit at a time. D6 and D7. Okay, so D3 is 0 XOR, D6 is 1 XOR 0. We have only one single one or odd number of one, so we'll have the value of P2 is 1. So here we'll have 1. Okay, now we have to calculate P4. So P4 is the XOR of bits. So what are the bits for P4? After P4, we have to consider the data bits. So we have to take 4 bits at a time because we have 4 here. Okay, so D5, D6 and D7, we have to do the XOR operation. D5, D6 and D7. So what are the values of D5, D6 and D7? So we have 0, 1 and 0. So here we'll have 0 XOR, 1 XOR, 0. So here we'll have 1. So this P4 value is again 1. So we have to put it here. Now we have this 7-bit composite word. So in the first part, we have to find out the 7-bit composite word. Here we have this part A. So part A solution, you will start from here. The composite word is equal to 0101010. So this is the solution of the first part of the problem. So in part B, we have to evaluate the 3 check bits C4, C2 and C1 assuming no error. Consider this composite word in part B, okay, as it is, because there is no error. So we have to consider this composite word and we have to find out the check bits C4, C2 and C1. And if we get 000 all the check bits, then there is no error. So in part B solution, we'll have the composite word is 0101010. So this is bit position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, these are the bit positions. So these are the bit positions. Now we have to find out the check bits C1. So C1 is the XOR of bits. So what are the bit positions? So bit positions will be starting from 1, we have to take 1 bit, then we have to skip another, then we'll take the 3rd bit, and we'll skip another 4th bit, okay, and we'll take the 5th bit, we'll skip the 6th bit, and we'll take the 7th bit, okay. So here we have to take the bit positions 1, 3, 5, 7. Now we have to take the bits in these bit positions, and we have to do the XOR operation. So in first position we have 0, in the third position we have 0 XOR, in the fifth position we have 0 XOR, in the seventh position also we have 0. So here we have all are 0, so the answer will be 0. Okay, that means check bit C1 is 0. Now we will consider the check bit C2. So the check bit C2, we have to do the XOR of bits. So 2, 3, then we have to skip 4 and 5, and 6 and 7. 2, 3, 6 and 7 position bits we have to consider, and we have to do the XOR operation between them. So here we'll have 1 XOR 0 XOR 6, 7 position bits are 1 XOR 0. So here we have 2 number of ones or even number of ones, so the answer will be 0. Okay, now let us calculate the check bit C4. C4 is the XOR of bits. So what are the bits for C4? We have to consider for the 4th bit. So 4, 5, 6 and 7. 4, 5, 6 and 7 bit we have to see here. So here we have 1, 0, 1, 0. So we have to do the XOR operation between them. 1, XOR 0, XOR 1, XOR 0. So here we have 2 number of 1, so answer will be 0. Therefore we have seen that C is equal to C4, C2, C1 equal to 0, 0, 0. So the decimal equivalent will be 0. That means there is no error. Therefore there is no error. So this is the solution of the second part of the problem. In the third part, we have to assume an error in the bit D5 during writing into the memory. Suppose there is an error in the bit D5 or the fifth position bit during writing into the memory, then so how the error in the bit is detected and corrected. So using this Hamming code, we will detect this error. So initially we will take that there is an error in the bit D5. In part C, we have the original bit sequence is 0101010. So this is the original bit sequence. Now we have an error in the fifth position bit, that is 1 2 3 4 fifth position. So let me write down here 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7 position. So in this fifth position bit, this 0, there is an error. So what will be the value? So this 0 will be 1. Therefore, with error in D5, that is data 5, the composite sequence will be, so what will be the composite sequence? 0101, then 110. Okay, this is the fifth bit. Okay, D5. So here we have an error now. So the bit positions are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So these are the bit positions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we will calculate the check bits and we will detect the error and we will correct it. So C1, so we have already seen C1 is the XOR of bits. So what are the bits? 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, so 1, 3, 5, 7, 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, XOR, 0, XOR, 1, XOR, 0. So here we have only single one. So the XOR operation will give one value. C2 is equal to XOR of bits 2, 3, 6, 7. So similar to the previous case I have considered here. So here we'll have 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3 is 1, 0, 1, 0. So 1 XOR, 0 XOR, 1 XOR, 0. So what we'll have here, it is 0 because we have two number of ones or even number of ones. Now we'll find out C4. C4 is the XOR of bits 4, 5, 6 and 7 position bits. So 4, 5, 6, 7 position bits are 1110. So here we'll have 1 XOR, 1 XOR, 1 XOR, 0. So here we'll have three number of ones. So the event parity, if we consider, will have one value. Okay, so we have got C equal to C4, C2, C1 equal to 101. Okay, this is the decimal number. So this is the binary number. Okay, so what will be the decimal value? So it is 5 in decimal. So there is an error in the fifth position. Therefore, we have to complement this fifth position bit. That is, we have to correct it. Now, it is easy because it is in digital electronics, we have only 0 and 1. So if it is by mistake, it is 1, then this should be 0. Therefore, the corrected bit sequence will be 0101. Then we have an error and with that, we have got 1, but this should be 0. 1 0. This is the fifth bit. It was previously 1, by error it was detected as 1. Now we have got this 0, that is we have corrected it now. So this is the solution of the third part of the problem. Now let us go to our fourth part of the problem, that is part D. So in the fourth part of the problem, we have to add an parity bit P8. So in the fourth part of the problem, we have to add a parity bit P8 to include double error detection in the code. Assume that the errors occurred in bit P2 and D5. Okay, so we have to consider an error in bit P2 and D5. So then we have to show how the double error is detected. Okay, bit position. Here we have this bit position are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have to add one extra bit. So up to here we have, so the original bit sequence is, original bits are, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is the original bit sequence. So there was no 8th bit. Now we are given that we have an error in this bit position 2 and bit position 5. Okay, so if we have 1, this should be 0 to make an error. And if it is 0, we have to make it 1 for an error. With error in P2 and D5 is equal to P2 and D5. So this is P2. So let me write down here. This is P1, P2, D3, P4, D5, D6, D7. We have to add one extra bit here, parity bit. So that is P8. Okay. So we have to consider now there is an error in P2 and D5. So 0 will remain as it is. So this is the original bit. So now there is an error in P2. So this 1 will become 0. Okay, D3 will remain as it is, 0, 1, and we have an error in D5 as well. So here we'll have 1, then we'll have, this is D6 is 1 and D7 is 0. Okay, now if we see the original parity in the composite word, so what we'll have, 1, 2, 3 number of 1s, so here we'll have 1. Now in this sequence also we have the parity is 1. So we have 1 here. We have to now see the check bits. So C1 is the XOR of bits 1, 3, 5, 7. So what we'll have? 1, 3, 5, 7. So 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, XOR, 0, XOR, 1, XOR, 0. So here we have only single one. So what we'll have, the C1 value will be 1. Now let us find out C2. C2 is the XOR of bits. So here we'll have 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, then 4, 5 we have to skip. Okay, 2, 3, 6, 7. So here we have 2 is 0, 0, 1 and 0. So 0 XOR 0 XOR 1 XOR 0. So what will have? We have only single one. So what will happen? We'll have 1 here. Now we have to calculate C4. C4 is the XOR of bits. So what are the bits? So 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we have to skip 8 bit, 9 bit, 10 and 11 bit. Only we have the 8 bit, so we have to skip the 8 bit. So 4, 5, 6, 7. So here we have 1, 1, 1, 0. So 1 XOR, 1 XOR, 1 XOR, 0. Okay. So here we have 3 number of 1s. That is odd number of 1s. So here we'll have 1. Therefore, C equal to C4, C2, C1 equal to 1, 1, 1. And this is not equal to 0. Okay, so for double error, the condition is C should be not equal to 0 and P should be 0. Therefore, we can write, so if P equal to 0 and this is the given and we have obtained this C not equal to 0 and C not equal to 0, then we have double error. Then we have double error. So if the parity is equal to 0 and the C value is not equal to 0, that is the check bits are not equal to 0, okay, then we have a double error. Okay, so this is the solution of the problem number 7.14. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.